Today we are going to start a new chapter, Kings, Farmers and Towns, Early States and Economies. This is the second chapter of the first book of history. In the first chapter you studied about Indus Valley Civilization. In the second, third and fourth chapter, which is in first book, you will be studying about the history of 6th century BC to 6th century AD. In this chapter, you will be studying about the political life, the political development that took place in your country between 6th century BC to 6th century AD. You have also studied in the first chapter that one of the reasons that has been suggested by the historians of the decline of the Indus Valley Civilization was coming of the Aryans. The Aryans were basically pastoralist. They didn't know the art of agriculture. They used to rear animals. They were cattle herders. And they started migrating from Central Asia and started shifting to different parts of the world. And one branch of the Aryans shifted towards south and southeast and ultimately came to India. They reached the banks of Indus, the Saraswati River, and settled over there. Whether this assertion of the historians that the Indus Valley Civilization was destroyed by the Aryans is correct or not, we can't say that with certainty. There several reasons have been suggested. You have read, you have studied in the last chapter about the decline of the Indus Valley Civilization. However, whatever the reasons might have been, the Aryans started coming and settling in the Indus Valley region, especially on the banks of the river Saraswati, after or towards the end of the Indus Valley Civilization. From then started what we call in history of our country as a Vedic period. The Vedas were written during that period. And that period is also identified in history as the Vedic civilization. That further is divided as early Vedic period and later Vedic period. You don't have to study these things in the syllabus of history of class 12. You have to start from 6th century BC and study the events that happened in your country up to 6th century AD, that is the ancient period, after the Vedic period. So if we see what happened in your country between this period, that is 6th century BC and 6th century AD, we find that the Aryans, who were basically pastoralist, they started settling in different parts of the Indo-Gangetic Basin, and they started living in villages because they didn't knew about city life. So that was the beginning of the Aryan civilization. Slowly, these centers of establishment of the Aryans, it started growing up in size and started becoming political centers. It started developing into urban centers, and these started to be known as Janpads, in which some of them became bigger and they came to be known as Mahajanpads. We'll be discussing about this today in our history class. I have told you that some of the villages started growing into bigger centers of human establishment, which came to be known as Janpads. And some of these Janpads became important, bigger and powerful, which came to be known as Mahajanpats, which further grew into kingdoms. And later on, the first empire was formed in your country, which you know as the Mauryan Empire. We will be studying about these things in this chapter. This development started taking place from 6th century BC onwards in the Indo-Gangetic Plain. So basically we will be confining in this chapter our discussion about the developments taking place in our country between 6th century BC to 6th century AD. Especially the political developments we will be discussing in this chapter. All the remaining three chapters that we have to study in this book one, that is related with the history of 6th century BC to 6th century AD. And the second chapter is about the political development that took place during this period. This 6th century BC occupies a very significant place in the history of India. Actually, Indian history underwent many important political, economic, social, and religious changes during this period. From 6th century BC onwards, iron came into a wide use in Eastern UP and Western Bihar. The importance of the warrior class started increasing during this period because of the use of iron weapons, because better weapons could be made now with the help of iron. The earlier metals that were used that were not as strong as iron. So use of iron gave an extra edge to those political units which had access to iron. You will see the importance of that in the coming part of the chapter. This also helped in the growth of or increase in agricultural production, because now agricultural tools became better, and which helped in doing cultivation in a better way, and ultimately that led to the increase in agricultural production. Besides, military strength also started growing with the improvement in economic condition and the use of iron weapons. This resulted in the growth of warrior class, who became engaged in expansion of their territories. All this ultimately led to the establishment of kingdoms and large empires. There were 16 states or Mahajanpats in the 6th century BC. And that is also mentioned in some Buddhist and Jain literary works. Some of the important Mahajanpats were Vaji, Magad, Khosla, Kuru, Panchal, Gandhar, and Avanti. There were other Mahajanpats like Ang, Mal, Kashi, Vats, Chedi, Sursen, Matasya, Asmak, Kamboj. So these were the 16 Mahajanpats that got formed as political units that got formed as small states, small centers of powers in the Indo-Gangetic Plain, in different parts of the Indo-Gangetic Plain in the 6th century BC. Some of these Mahajanpats were republics like Vaji, Mal, Sursena, etc. Whereas greater number of Mahajanpats were monarchies. The Mahajanpats which used to be republic, they actually used to be a confederacy of different clans. For example, Vaji was a confederacy of 8 clans. And out of these different clans, the Lichavis and the Jantrikas were the most important. You must have heard about Lord Mahavir, who was the 24th Tirthankara of the Jains. He belonged to the Jantrika tribe. which was a part of the confederacy of the Vajis. Besides, Lord Buddha or Mahatma Buddha was associated with the Sakya Republic of Kapilvastu. So these were the 16 important Mahajanapads which got formed during the 6th century BC. And out of these Mahajanapads, some of them became very powerful, and ultimately a fight between these Mahajanapads started for supremacy, and which ultimately led to the formation of the first empire in your country.